extra food, specialty heated dens, and warm blankets of straw. Even the Greenville Zoo is getting ready for this brutally cold weather. Here's News 4's Gordon Dill.
These ladies like it the least. Spider monkeys, a mother and daughter from the equator and unprepared for this kind of weather.
With the long digits they have for swinging through the trees and everything, they're real susceptible to frostbite and things like that.
That means if you don't see them hanging out, they've curled up inside where the heaters run all day. Lions have special accommodations too. They're licking their lips at the thought of eating us, but luckily they're especially well fed in the cold. The meals get much larger.
Yeah, we increase it just about 25% for the cold of the winter. And then come spring, we'll bump them back down so they don't get overweight.
That means he eats about 12 pounds of food every day. She gets about 9, and the extra food keeps them extra insulated. In short, Greenville Zoo has even the most sensitive animals ready for the cold. The real challenge is out here. Unlike last December, which was warm and in the middle of a drought, this month, with bitter cold and rain every weekend, the human animals have been far less likely to show up. Attendance is down, which means people may be missing out on those animals that really thrive this time of year, like these red pandas. There are two now. The male just arrived to try and breed. They prefer the cold. And if it's cold enough, they may have most of the zoo to themselves. Gordon Dill, WYFF News 4, Greenville.
So, Carol, if I eat more, will I stay warmer?
I think so.
Huh. Good to know. The zoo is still open for its regular hours in the winter, and while some animals like the elephants won't be out because it's too cold, there'll still be plenty of other animals to see.